Hey guys, what's up? I wanted to show you guys something a little different aside from the guns and stuff and shooting. So I want to show you guys how to make a swinging target, or at least a target to shoot at. Now this will work for most calibers, as far as pistols, and I'm talking about from 22 to 9 millimeter, or it just depends on what kind of steel you get. So let me show you kind of what we're going to be making here today. So this is just a rebar frame, okay, and it's bent at two positions, and it has a steel plate here, swinging steel plate, a couple of S hooks, and a T for a third leg, and I'll show you guys how that works. Now, let me show you guys what you'll be needing. You'll definitely need a propane torch. I don't know if propane will actually be hot enough to heat up the rebar and bend it. So I do have one of these little mini blow torches that are, they mock an acetylene oxygen set, but they're not the same, so you don't need the licensing or anything like that. So all this is just an oxygen tank here, and this is a MAP gas, which is max power propylene. Yeah, MAP. Yeah, that's exactly what it is. All it is just like a hotter version of propane. It burns hotter. So you could use this whole system with propane and oxygen, or propane and MAP. I recommend propane and MAP because this will burn hotter and get you up to temp faster. And then this is the actual torch head right here. Just a small regular torch head. This is all it comes with for heating up stuff. You can even cut with it, but that's not what we're doing here today. And then these are obviously the fittings you hook up there. You'll definitely need one sparker or a lighter or something to ignite your torches. Now, as far as the stuff you'll be needing to assemble this, I have here a half inch steel or iron T, and I'll show you guys how this will work and what you'll be using it for exactly. A couple S hooks. These are just a couple of random ones. I think it's probably better to buy the thicker ones. There are thicker ones you can get, and this is all I had right now. And then up here you have to have obviously a measuring tape and some kind of tool to mark where you'll be cutting and bending and whatnot. Either a piece of chalk or a marker. This is like a crayon, but a chalk would probably work better. And then obviously your target. Now this can vary from all kinds of thicknesses. This here is, jeez, I think it's probably, hold on, let me get my measuring tape here and let's see if we can measure this real quick. Let's measure this. I think it's like less than a quarter inch or so. So from the 1 inch mark, bring it to the 1 inch mark right there. Oh, it is a quarter inch. So it's quarter inch steel plate. This is definitely not like an AR 500 or anything like that. Not hardened steel or anything. It's just had some steel sitting around. Now you can use diamond plate if you want to make a 22 target, but for anything like for handguns or anything, I think you're going to need at least a quarter inch or thicker, and it doesn't have to be hardened steel. And then for the main component, you're going to need is rebar. So here I have a 10 inch piece, a 10, sorry, 10 foot piece, as well as a 5 foot piece right here. This one on the right, that's a 5 foot piece because we had already cut one apart to make this one up here. So also I forgot to mention is you'll probably be needing one of these to cut the rebar, or you can buy it from Home Depot pre-cut. So that's probably a good option to do. Let me put this back because we've already cut our piece, so we don't need to do that. And now the first thing I should probably explain to you before we get started is this is a 5 foot piece overall, so we're going to bend it at the 2 foot mark and the other side from a 2 foot mark and leave this about a foot. It won't be exact, so it doesn't have to be exact, but that's the rough dimensions that I have here. So each leg is about 2 feet tall, and then the width is about a foot or so. It's actually like 14 inches and this is like 23. Okay, so here I have already a measuring tape set up at 5 feet right next to where we want to start, and we want to count it off to foot number 2, and we want to mark at exactly 2 feet and then 1 inch above and below it. And the reason for that is we want to heat up right here at the exact 2-foot mark and make the bend there. The beauty with this little torch here is that this tip allows you to heat up in a small spot, and it will bend exactly there. So you can probably kind of see that, like right there. It's like a perfect 90-degree bend, and it's exactly where we wanted it. And so the next mark you'll make from 2 feet would be at the other end. You'd count from 5, obviously, to 3 for the other 2-foot mark, and make your other mark here, here, and here. So what that'll do is between 3 feet and 4 feet, that's where your target's going to hang from and swing. All right. So let me set up the tripod and let me get this rebar up here so we can heat it up. So here I have it clamped in the vise here. I got the first 2-foot piece, and here's my very first mark here. And I got it, there you go. There you can see it. That's exactly the 2-foot mark, and that's 1 inch below, and that's 1 inch above. So I have my 2-foot mark here, and that's where I'm going to heat it up. And when I heat it up, it's going to get so soft there that it's not going to want to bend from right here. It's going to want to bend exactly where I heated it up from. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to preheat it with a propane torch so I don't waste the oxygen and the map gas, because that stuff is really expensive, actually. So let's go ahead and start with that. So you're just going to heat it up just at that point, and you'll see some condensation forming. See how it's like a little wet? Because the steel's really cold. So if I get through that phase, and there, it's starting to dry up. I'm going to let it heat up for maybe a few minutes, and then I'm going to hit it with the torch, and I'll show you guys that in a little bit. So here it's been about two and a half minutes now, probably 3 minutes, and it looks to be pretty warm. There's not much condensation there anymore. So we're going to start here with the other torch here, the oxygen torch. So let me start that up. The key with this thing is trying to get it to, trying to get the flame to set correctly. Go ahead, back that one off. Now, you may wonder when it's ready to, you know, actually start bending. And if you just pull on the bar a little bit, if you pull on the bar, you'll notice when it starts getting soft. And then that's when you can actually make the full bend. And you'll kind of be able to tell that it's getting cherry red when it's ready. So let's go ahead and get this going. Now I'm trying to heat it up from all the way around, so it'll make it a little faster and easier. And it's probably good to do it when it's a little bit darker, so that you can see when it's starting to change colors. Let me adjust the flame a little bit. It's getting there now, where I can see it's actually pretty close to red. See if I can get it a little close up. Let's pull it off for just a second. Go ahead and go back. Yeah, it's getting soft, but it's almost there. Here I increased the oxygen to get it to go really hot. Yeah, so it's almost there. So see how it's starting to bend? So you can go ahead and pull off the flame now. Go ahead and kill it. And complete the whole bend. And make sure it's 90 degrees. You can just eyeball it and get it. And that looks like to be a 90 degrees right there. Let me shut off this. Let me show you guys the bend right there. So that appears to be 90 degrees, pretty close, pretty good. All right, so let me, I'm gonna cool this down by actually taking it outside and smothering it in the dirt. Not pouring water on it or anything. You don't want to do that because you don't want to make it really brittle. So let me go ahead and do that, and then we'll show you guys the next step. So here we flipped it around, and now we have the side we just bent on the right side, and we also slipped on the T. This is very important that you do this now and not forget afterwards, because when you try to slide it on afterwards, you won't be able to make it around the bend. So make sure you put that on before you put on, before you flip it and start to heat up the next mark you made, which would be 2 feet from here to here, right? So that means that you have about a foot in between here, which would be in between foot marks 2 and 3. So let's go ahead and heat this up and bend it over. Oh, it's also imperative to make sure that you have this to be level, so that when you bend it and you make the full U, that it's not torqued out of angle. And you guys will see that when we're bending it, we'll be like messing around with it and stuff. So I'll get to that in a little bit. So let me set you guys up here and show you how we're going to heat up the second side. So here we've got it heated up cherry red. Now go ahead and shut it off. That's actually way too hot. You don't need it to be that hot. And shut off the nap gas. Okay, and then we're just going to complete the bend. And go ahead and make it a 90 degree. Probably want to go over just a little bit more because it wants to bend back out. That's very hot. I can feel the heat from that. So here, this is what you should end up with after you make that last bend. Looks a little bowed out. That's not bad. Actually, it's gonna be perfect. All right, so go ahead and let it cool down, and then we'll move to the next step, which would be hanging the target. And so here we have the finished product, pretty much. All that's left is assembly. So you gotta assemble your frame with your target, and also whatever scrap rebar you have left, you have to turn that into a third leg for the T. And I'll show you guys how that's assembled right now. And this can be anything. It doesn't have to be a scrap piece of rebar. You can have like another small tube or something like that. So let's go ahead and set this up. You want to try to put it in the middle, and the whole point is that you shove in the two front legs obviously into the ground, and then the third leg will go into the back to give it some support. And that's a pretty long leg, so that's going to go into the ground. You got to drive that into the ground a little bit, and also you got to drive these feet into the ground as well, so you have some pretty good stability. And so you'll end up with a finished product kind of looking like this. So let's go ahead and hang the other target on this one so you can see what they both look like. So you take these S-hooks and go ahead and just put them on the plate first. And these holes you can make with either a drill or a blowtorch or something like that if you got access to it. And then all you do is just hang it on, just like that. And that's pretty high up now because it's sitting on concrete. However, you can even hang these lower with a little piece of chain. Just bring it down a little lower, a little piece of chain like this. So that's always possible. And it takes recoil pretty well because it's a swinging target. So you really don't have to worry about the frame so much. It looks like it's really skinny. It's not going to hold up or anything like that. Actually, it will, because most of the energy being transferred is going straight to the steel target. It's going straight to the steel target and not so much to the frame. Now, you could hit the frame, you know, with a round. That's possible. But it really doesn't do too much damage. So that's I think we have some hit marks on this one right down here, and they really didn't do much. So that's how you guys make a swinging target here, and I just wanted to share that with you guys. Again, it can work for anything from 22 to even handgun calibers. Just depends on what kind of steel you got laying around or what kind of steel you can get access to. So to tally up the total cost here, it looks like the rebar cost about $5, and that was for 10 feet. So if you have about 5 feet, it's going to be, you know, probably half that or around less than that. And you can even get smaller ones, you know, 18 inches, 2 feet. You can find that all at Home Depot. This is half-inch rebar. I don't think I said that in the beginning. And so the total cost, I would say, is about less than $10, even if you were to buy S-hooks and whatnot. As far as your steel plate, if you have something laying around, that'd be nice. If you have to buy like a little bit of steel from Home Depot, I think they have some kind of thicker steels you can find. Or if not, you can find it from a hardware store or something like that. You can probably get it for really cheap. So all in all, definitely under $20. You know, I would say closer to $10-$15. And I think it'd be better than what you could buy online as far as handling recoil and being very lightweight. And a pretty big target, so you can actually hit it, because we have one of those smaller targets that are about 3-inch in diameter, and they're really hard to hit. At least with this, you can, you know, hit the corner and still be satisfied. You know, you hit the ring, you hit it, and it rings, and you're pretty happy about it. So that's all I pretty much wanted to show you guys today. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you guys have any comments or questions or anything like that, please leave them below or send me a private message. I really don't mind. All right, guys, I'll talk to you later.